Hi, I'm Ben Marriott, I make weekly motion design tutorials, and this week we're going to talk through how I made that 2D, cell-looking transition effect, all in After Effects. Let's begin.
Let's start in a new comp called Spread, and we've got a transparency on, and the first thing we're going to do is draw a little blob in the middle. So let's turn our title action safe on to get a little crosshair so we know where the middle is, and zoom in a bit. And with that pen tool selected, I've got it on no fill and then on a sort of very dark gray stroke set to 6 pixels. We're just gonna draw a rough sort of blobby shape in the middle. There we go. Now I'm gonna select the timeline down here or anywhere just to click off of that shape. And then I'm gonna draw another shape, which will create a new shape layer. And I'm just gonna draw around that shape again in another rough sort of blobby fashion. And from here, you can move the anchor point to sort of, you know, finesse the shape a bit to your liking. Because this is, you know, going to be such a loose sort of look that we're after, I'm not going to worry too much about that. And then I'm going to repeat that process again, and each time just drawing fairly close to the original shape and, you know, not being too precious to follow the original curves in that shape either. Just sort of getting a rough shape on there. All right, and now I'm going to continue to do this until we reach the whole edge of our frame. It won't take that long. I think this will take probably less than 15 minutes. But let's meet back here in that time. All right, now I'm gonna draw one last layer, which is just gonna cover the complete composition. All right, now that didn't take too long, but it was very tedious. Perfect time to, you know, put on a podcast or audiobook or Lil Nas X on repeat. Now I'm just going to go through and make sure if there's any areas in here that I want to clean up. Maybe this area down here is just a little too straight, so I'm just going to make some slight adjustments to that. But otherwise, I think I'm pretty happy. All right, now we're happy with all our shapes. Let's sequence them so we can see them animating. To do that, I'm going to select them all with Control A and move my playhead to the second frame, hold Alt Option and click the right square bracket. And that's going to trim them all to play just 2 frames. And now to sequence them, you want to select the one you want first in the sequence, which in our case is the bottom one, hold shift, click the top one, right click and select keyframe assistant, sequence layers, and click OK. And that's gonna play them. And if we play that back, look at that. Got an animation going. We might need to extend our comp a little bit as well. There we are. And for our last frame, I'm probably gonna spread that out a few more frames. And let's trim our comp to that length. There we are. Now this is the point where you want to adjust any frames you have. If it's going too slow, you can delete some frames. If you don't like some of the shapes, you can get rid of those. But I'm pretty happy with this for now. So I'm going to select all of our frames with Control A, and I'm going to select our palette over here that I've already created in Illustrator, and then select the fill on these, select the eyedropper, and I'm just going to hover over till we get this dark orange. Perfect. And now I've got this in orange. Actually, let's rename this comp to comp spread orange 1. Duplicate it with Command D. We'll do that twice. So we've got orange 1, orange 2, and orange 3. And I'm going to select orange 2, select them all, choose our palette, select that lighter orange. There we are. And do that for the third one as well. All right, now with those 3 comps selected, I'm gonna drag them down to our new composition window, click OK, and that's gonna create a new composition with all of those inside. Let's go through and recolor these to make it a bit clearer. Now we're gonna sequence these layers, but I think this time it's probably best to do it manually. So I'm gonna drag this one 4 frames across, same with this one, and after playback, we should be able to see the basics of our animation. Look at that, all right, starting to take shape. Now let's duplicate these 3 layers by selecting them, pressing Command D and Command right bracket to bring them all up. And then I'm gonna shift them across 4 frames. So now it repeats more. Do that one more time with them all selected again. And I'm gonna do that one more time. And extend the comp a little bit as well. Now we've got pretty much the bulk of our animation made. Now we could have sequenced our layers using the keyframe assistant sequence layers, but because we have these in a very specific order of the different colors, thought it'd be easier to do them manually without reshuffling, and it doesn't really take that long. So now that we've got this sort of psychedelic tunnel sort of opening, we want the end to be transparent. So to do that, I'm going to duplicate this last layer. I'm going to color that a different color. I'm going to call that spread end. And I want to change its blending mode to stencil alpha, which is just going to create like an alpha mat for all the layers. There we are. Now you notice we don't have a stroke on this last shape here. So to do that, I'm just going to duplicate another one of these comps over here, call it spread stroke. Inside that, I'm going to select everything, hold alt, and just click on fill until we get no fill. And then back in our transition, I'm going to add that stroke layer on top over here. There we go. And these two comps, we can drag them anywhere to close off the comp a little earlier. So if we drag them across here, that's just going to close up and eat all our composition there where we have it. You can even drag them right up to the front here, to where the second composition starts, and then you just get this one ring of animation happening. And you could even use that for some sort of like, I don't know, energy blast or something. If someone punches or makes an impact, you get this little psh, radiating outwards. But for us, I think we want to have at least one frame where the whole composition is filled with this sort of animation, which would be around here. There we are. And I'll just trim these comps at the back here. And now if we play it, the transition fills up the screen and then wipes it away. Now you could also set this up by only using one comp instead of these three. And to do that, you make one comp and let's just call this black white. And in that comp, you'd give everything a white fill and a completely black stroke, not that dark gray. And then in a new comp with that layer, you duplicate it a few times. And then you can add the tint effect from over here in the effects presets panel, and then map the white to whatever color you want. Copy that effect, apply it to another layer, and then you can change the color from here as well. And there you go. But the benefit of using a separate comp for each color is that we can add something like a texture to that comp, so that to preserve underlying transparency. And you've got a texture over all that comp. Let's change its colors with the curves. Bump that up quite a bit. Get some nice contrast. Let's invert that as well. And we're gonna change the blending mode to multiply. There we are. And when we go back into our transition comp, you'll see that all instances of that color have that texture applied, which can give a neat look if you want to apply that to all of the different layers. But let's turn that off for now. Now let's trim this transition comp to where everything is now transparent, which is here. Press N on our keyboard, right click, trim comp to work area. Now if you've got an edit where you've got two pieces of footage that you want to transition between, you can simply drag that transition over your comp. Play back, you got this nice little psychedelic transition. The project for this is available for download down in the description. If you've used anything you've learned in this tutorial, please tag me on Instagram at ben_married_ so I can take a look and to give you lots of compliments. I can't wait to see what you make.
Please let me know down in the comments what else you'd like to see from this channel. Would you like some more tutorials, some more process videos, a breakdown of the tools I use? I'd love to know. And don't forget to subscribe, share, hit that bell icon, and like. I'll see you next week.